another chorus of death. It's part of the truth of Palm Sunday, isn't it? Our fickleness to praise God one day and betray Him the next. Let us admit the truth about ourselves as we come together and pray our prayer of confession together, and then there'll be some time for silent prayer. Let us pray. We love praise. We love the excitement, the colors, the noise. Today we celebrate Jesus' entry into Jerusalem. His followers have stripped branches from the trees and waved them in the air. They have thrown their clothes in the path of the donkey that his steps might be cushioned. And the scene is wonderful, but there is a reality. Got little leaves on them, see the little leaves like the palms?
Lord God, thank you for Palm Sunday. Thank you for saving us. Help us to always use our palms.
Help us to always use our palms.
To remember to pray to you. And praise you. In Jesus' name. I want you to imagine with me this morning, what would you be doing that first Palm Sunday? If you were on that route into Jerusalem and saw Jesus coming and you'd heard about him and heard what he'd been doing, if you had felt this air of expectancy and excitement as if something big was about to happen, even if you weren't quite sure what, what would you be doing? Would you be off to the side, curious, wondering, holding back? Or would you be one of those in the midst of the throng, throwing your cloak in the path, waving your palm branch, shouting Hosanna. Maybe you were doing something else, like getting out of there as fast as you could. What would you be doing? Mark's account of Palm Sunday, compared to the other Gospels, is definitely the most subdued. Could you tell that? There are no huge crowds coming out from the city, no titles for Jesus, no